गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट. इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी आर स्टडीड ऑलरेडी क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ पॉलीमर ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ मोड ऑफ पॉलीमराइजेशन. देन नेक्स्ट क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ पॉलीमर ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ टाइप ऑफ मोनोमर यूज्ड. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ पॉलीमर्स डिपेंडिंग ऑन टाइप ऑफ मोनोमर यूज्ड. फर्स्ट इज होमोपॉलीमर. होमो मीन्स इट इज लैटिन वर्ड. Its meaning is one. Homo means one. Therefore, polymer which are obtained by only one type of monomer called as homopolymer. For example, polythene. Example, polythene. It consists of only one type of monomer, that is ethylene. Monomer of polythene is ethylene, and from ethylene, n number of ethylene molecules are polymerized to form polyethylene. Therefore, it is type of homopolymer. Second is copolymer. Polymers which are obtained by different types of monomer called as copolymers. For example, Buna S. This Buna S rubber, it is a type of rubber. Buna S rubber. It is also called as styrene butadiene rubber. Its monomers are 1,3-butadiene, 1,3-butadiene and styrene. These are the monomers for Buna S rubber. It is also called as SBR. Styrene butadiene rubber. It is copolymer which is formed by two different monomer, that is 1,3-butadiene and styrene. This is the classification on the basis of type of monomers used. Then next classification, fifth classification, on the basis of biodegradability. There are again two types of polymers which are biodegradable polymers and non-biodegradable. First is biodegradable polymers and second is non-biodegradable. Polymers. First of all, what is meant by biodegradable polymer? Polymer which are degraded by microbes in environment called as biodegradable polymer. Biodegradable polymer does not cause pollution in the environment. There are examples of biodegradable polymers are PHBV. Then nylon 2, nylon 6, nylon 2, nylon 6. These are the biodegradable polymer which does not cause pollution in the environment because they are degraded by the microbes in the environment. Then non-biodegradable polymers, for example, thermocol. It is obtained from styrene as a monomer. It is non-biodegradable polymer. Therefore, this polymer is banned. These are the five types of classification of the polymer on the different basis. Then next point is some important polymers. First is rubber. Elastomers are popularly called as rubbers. We know that there are many uses of rubber in manufacture of balloons, shoe soles, tires, toys, etc. Then natural rubber, monomer of natural rubber is isoprene. Monomer of natural rubber is isoprene. It is common name of 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene that is butadiene means parent is butane, consists of 4 carbon atom at 2 position, suppose first carbon atom, second carbon atom, third carbon atom and 4 carbon atom. At second position there is 1 methyl group, 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Its parent is alkene because ENE represents alkene. At 1 and 3 position there is double bond and remainings are hydrogen CH3. This is the monomer of natural rubber, that is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. It is high molecular mass linear polymer. Which type of natural rubber is, which type of polymer? It is linear or straight chain polymer, which is obtained by monomer 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Then what is the reaction if EN times isoprene, that is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene, is polymerized by, we know that monomers containing double bond or monomers that are vinyl monomers, vinyl chloride monomers and alkene monomers undergo addition polymerization by using free radical mechanism. In last lecture we are already studied what is meant by free radical mechanism. Therefore this polymerization is takes place in presence of peroxide. What is the role of peroxide in this polymerization? Because it is obtained by free radical mechanism by using initiators. First step is chain initiation. For chain initiation, free radical is required. That free radical is formed from this peroxide. Then this type of polymer is formed . This is your natural rubber. Natural rubber. This is the reaction of natural rubber. It is also called as polyisoprene. Polyisoprene. Then properties of natural rubber. First is it has cis configuration of carbon-carbon double bond. First property of natural rubber or polyisoprene is configuration of this double bond is cis configuration. It consists of various chains held together by van der Waals forces. Third property, it can be stretched like spring. It can be stretched like spring and show elastic property. Then vulcanization of rubber. Next is important property
of natural rubber is vulcanization of rubber. Vulcanization of rubber.
First of all, what is mean by vulcanization? To improve physical properties of natural rubber, process by which network of crosslink is introduced in the natural rubber by addition of sulfur. Generally, sulfur is used for formation of network of crosslink in natural rubber. Therefore, sulfur is used for vulcanization of natural rubber. Then effect of vulcanization. What is the effect of vulcanization? Vulcanization enhances the properties of natural rubber, such as tensile strength increases, stiffness increases, elasticity increases, toughness increases. For multiple choice, one question will be asked. For vulcanization, which element is used? Sulfur. Generally, sulfur is used for vulcanization of rubber. Vulcanization enhances the properties of the rubber. Why sulfur is used for vulcanization? Because sulfur can form crosslink between polyisoprene, and due to network of crosslink, properties of natural rubber enhances. Then next polymer is second polymer is polyethylene. Polyethylene has two types. First is low density polyethylene and high density polyethylene. First, low density polyethylene. In short, it is also called as LDP, low density polyethylene. Monomer is ethene or ethylene. It is obtained by addition polymerization of ethylene under high pressure of 1000 to 2000 atmosphere, and temperature is about 350 to 570 Kelvin temperature. In presence of traces of oxygen or peroxide as a initiator, because this polymer is also obtained by addition polymerization by free radical mechanism. Then what is the reaction? Low density polyethylene. CH2 double bond CH2. It is the monomer. Monomer of low density polyethylene is polyethylene. Polymerization carried out in presence of high pressure of 1000 to 2000 atmosphere and temperature is about 350 to 570 Kelvin temperature, in presence of traces of oxygen or peroxide. What is the role of oxygen or peroxide in this reaction? These are act as the initiator for chain initiation for free radical mechanism to form polyethylene. N times, this is polyethylene, but this is low density polyethylene. Why this polyethylene is called as low density polyethylene? Because chains are loosely held by van der Waals forces, therefore polymer has low density. Then properties of this polymer are, it is flexible, tough, chemically inert, moisture resistant. It is flexible, tough, chemically inert and moisture resistant. These are the properties of low density polythene. It is one most important property of polythene is it is poor conductor of electricity. Therefore, it is used in manufacture of pipes for irrigation, pipes for agriculture, insulation for electrically conducting wire, preparation of squeeze bottle and attractive containers. Then next is second type of polythene is high density polythene. High density polythene. It is also called as HDP, high density polythene. Reaction is same as low density polythene, but conditions of polymerization are changes. It is also linear polymerization obtained by addition polymerization. It has high density due to close packing. It has high density due to close packing, but this polymerization takes place in presence of low pressure as compared to low density polythene, that is 6 to 7 atmosphere only, and temperature is 333 Kelvin to 343 Kelvin. Then what is the reaction? Reaction is same, only polymerization conditions are changed. Pressure is about only 6 to 7 atmosphere and temperature is 333 Kelvin to 343 Kelvin. This reaction is also carried out in presence of peroxide, because this polymer is also formed by addition polymerization by free radical mechanism. This is high density polythene. This polythene having high density because of close packing. Properties of high density polythene: it has high tensile strength, hardness, more resistant to chemical as compared to low density polythene. Therefore, high density polythene is used in manufacture of toys, household articles such as buckets, dustbins, bottles, pipes, laboratory wares. Then next is third polymer is polytetrafluoroethylene. Third, polytetrafluoroethylene. Polytetrafluoroethylene. In short, its trade name is Teflon. It is also called as polytetrafluoroethylene, PTFE. That means polytetrafluoroethylene. Its monomer is tetrafluoroethylene. Tetrafluoroethylene. What is the structure of ethylene? CH2 double bond CH2. This is the structure of ethylene. Ethylene, and its monomer is tetrafluoroethylene. That means these four hydrogen in ethylene are replaced by fluorine. Fluorine. This is the monomer for Teflon, that is polytetrafluoroethylene. Then what is the reaction? CF2 double bond CF2, that is tetrafluoroethylene, n times. This polymer is also obtained by addition polymerization. It is also linear polymer, which is obtained by addition polymerization by free radical mechanism in presence of peroxide as an initiator.
to form n times, it is Teflon or polytetrafluoroethylene.
Properties, it is tough, chemically inert. Most important property of this polymer is it is resistant to heat. Resistant to heat. Therefore, this polymer Teflon is used commonly used in manufacture of non-stick cookwares and oil seals. It is also chemically inert. But most important property of Teflon is it is resistant to heat, and therefore it is used in manufacture of non-stick cookware. Then next is fourth
polymer is polyacrylonitrile. Polyacrylonitrile, in short, it is also called as PAN, polyacrylonitrile.
It is also prepared by addition polymerization by free radical mechanism. It is also linear or straight chain polymer. Monomer is acrylonitrile.
Its monomer is acrylonitrile. Its formula is CH2 double bond CHCN. This is acrylonitrile.
Then reaction,
n number of acrylonitrile CN polymerize in presence of peroxide. It is act as initiator to form CH2CHCN n times. It is polyacrylonitrile.
Properties of polyacrylonitrile, it is similar to wool. It having similar properties to wool. Therefore, it is used as a wool substitute.
It is used as a wool substitute because it has
very similar properties to natural wool. It is also used for making Orlon.
It is also used for making Orlon.
Next polymer is polyamide polymers. We will discuss in next lecture.